Kind of a waste since it's already damaged. Oh, her hit points are out. How'd that happen? Because I wasn't paying attention. We can't heal her. Spirit magic. Oh, I didn't know we had that. I gotta try that next time. That's a yo-yo. I guess we can't use it down here? Oh, she can't use it on herself because she's out. Well, that makes sense. Are these the pills? Yet she's awake for this. It sure looks like it. Let's bring them to the captain right away. Found motion sickness pills. Yay, let's get the hell out of here. Figure she'll come back with one hit point. She's obviously still conscious for running around. Those rats are what's making this place creepy. Right. Without them, I'm not afraid of a dark storage like this. You're putting on a bold front. Oh no. What happened? Yeah, I can't run around all this time with her zero hit points. Basre says, "Coo, Mom! Basre! What happened?" Chris says, "He's sound asleep." Well, this is a problem. Are you alright, Uncle Hawk? Chris, is anything wrong? It seems my uncle is alright. Hey, Uncle, did you hear anything? No. Did something happen? The crew are all sleeping. Let's see. I may have heard a man's voice, but I'm not sure. A man's voice? I was thinking, so I can't say for sure. Oh no. Captain Jilba. I am turning the rudder. Even Captain Jilba is sound asleep. I have a bad feeling about this, Yo-Yo says. You need to go to our room and sleep. Clicking on the bed to try to sleep. Are they staying awake? Chris says. Do you think they're alright? Chris says, excuse me, are you okay? Sure, says, what do you mean you're okay? Didn't I tell you my partner is seasick? I guess they're fine. No, we're not fine, thanks to you, Goose says. Something is strange, Sherlock says. What's going on? This is not a good time for her to be at zero hit points and unable to heal herself. Or just someone else laying here. Bolto. Well, that really hit the spot. Even Bolto was asleep. Where is Mr. Heston? Can I look in these windows? No. Oh, they're out too. Look at that. Logi, you lovely pumpkin. He's still sleeping. Yo-yos, there's definitely something wrong. Right, let's check it out. Oh wait, you found something. Mind potion can't carry anymore. Well, can I use a potion then? Healing potion, duh. Oh, I forgot I had these. Wait. I can't use it. To wait till we're in combat? What does this do? Oh, awakens an unconscious character with its strong smell. Good thing we have this. We'll use this on Chris. Wow, and it completely heals too, at least at that level. Alright, we're good. I feel better now. Should we go check upstairs to see if anyone else is asleep? Are you still watching here? Oh god, he's out too. They are sleeping too. You mean he. That means... Hey, who is controlling the ship? Who? No one, obviously. Everyone is asleep. We must do something, otherwise this ship will go off its course. Yurio says, but Chris, we must catch the thief first. If we act quickly, we may be able to recover the stolen goods. But... do you know who the thief is? I guess so. Really? Maybe we should go over the facts then. Yeah, Yurio, fill us in, will ya? Yes. Then let's try solving this case, Chris says. What do you think their motive is? Steal guests' belongings. What has the thief stolen so far? A golden brooch. How did the thief make everyone fall asleep? Drug the tea. Yurio, who is the thief? It's not the mysterious couple. Because they did say that they didn't steal anything to themselves. Unless one of them snuck out and while the other one was sleeping, but I kind of don't think so. Uncle Hawk, I think, is a little too obvious. Wealthy Mr. Heston, maybe. Something is wrong. Let's go over things again. I guess that's not a correct answer. I don't think they'll wake up. Hey, Yurio, let's do some brainstorming to find out who the thief is. How about maybe stealing the ship? Well, we know it's a golden brooch. The fish is taken by the rats, right? But we did miss a coat and a watch. Drug the tea. Uncle Hawk? If their intention is to take control of the ship, why they make everyone fall asleep? So that they can bring the ship wherever they want to. Alright, so maybe it's just steal guests' belongings? Uncle Hawk? He's still my uncle, you know. He was locked in all this time, so it can't be Uncle Hawk. He wasn't locked in all this time. Yurio, you're awesome. So Mr. Heston is thief number A14 on the wanted notice. It's said that the thief uses sleeping pills. Notice Tanya's been sleeping the whole trip. Sorry guys. Excuse me. If Tanya was awake, no one could enter Logi and Tessa's room. I think that's why Tanya was drugged. But what about his stolen gold brooch? I think he's lying. No one would suspect him if he is also a victim. That's why you were opposed to leaving the silver dagger in our room. You didn't drink the tea because you thought it contained sleeping pills. No, I just don't like tea much. But you're still great. So, we now know Mr. Heston is a thief. Good job, Yurio. Well, it wasn't that difficult. Turn around. Chris says, oh, what? I heard something below. Everyone else is sleeping. That means Mr. Heston. Let's go. Is the chef asleep too? Go check on everybody else. It nicely done. Yep, sleeping. This should be empty here. And the one who was over here is, what's his name? He's down below now. Okay, so we've got multiple thieves on this ship. I wonder which one is more dangerous. Mr. Heston, quote unquote. There he is! Or the other two. Mr. Heston. I found him, Chris says. Well, we both found him. Whoa, he runs quickly. After him! I can't drink anymore. Well, is his room locked? Because he left it now. Well, we can't even try to get in there. Well, which way did he go? Did he run upstairs or down more? He probably ran down. That's what's in that briefcase. We must go after Mr. Heston, Chris says. Stay here, Captain Jilba. We'll go and catch Mr. Heston. Go! What? So there's a thief among the passengers. Chris, Yurio, you're the only ones who can catch the thief. Go quickly. Go where? I can't believe Mr. Heston did this. Are we going back down here then? I mean, I don't know if he ran down here or upstairs to the deck. I mean, this is an area where we have battles, so you might be here. Oh, what'd you find? Oh, can't carry any more mind potions. You can find a stimulant, will you? You could have a few more of those. Oh, we found something else. Well, I don't see him down here. So, I'm guessing he did run up then to the deck. What would you find now? A stimulant, thank you, I was asking for that. So we got back our stimulant that we just used. I don't think you have anything intelligent to say when you're asleep like that. Yurio, I saw Mr. Heston on the deck behind you. Behind you? Which way is behind? I guess behind is this way? Well, it's going to the bow because that is behind, isn't it? It's the aft, the front of the ship? There he is! Mr. Heston! Chris says, wait! No thief will wait for you, miss. Are we gonna do jump overboard? It's surprising that such youngsters like yourselves found out my true identity. But it's too late now. I couldn't get a hold of the silver dagger, but my collection is not bad. I don't think I'll ever see you again. Adios, amigos. What? What the? Heston says. Goose says it's your unlucky day, thief number A14. It's too bad, Sherla says. The use of sleeping pills is a basic technique of a thief. We knew what you were up to. Who are you? Sherla says, we can't tell you. We all have a past we want to keep secret, don't we? Goose says. What are you going to do, you gentleman wannabe of a thief? I won't forget about this. Whee! Did he jump overboard? Goose says, well, he is not that foolish. There must be a boat waiting for him nearby. Chris says, thank you very much. You helped us. They're out for themselves. They want what's in the bag. Hey, I remember you. You tried to steal the silver dagger. That's right, Yurio says. You were that other thief that pretended to be a female bard. My name is not that long. Chris says, you're trying to steal that bag too, aren't you? I won't let you get away with it. Goose says, that's why I didn't want to get out of the room. Give me Tess's coat, Chris says. I didn't do all that hard work for a mere thank you. Chris says, all thieves are fools, aren't they? A thief should behave like a thief. That's my motto. Goose says, Sherla! Oh, they're playing keep away. Yurio, Chris says. Go after her. How do I get up there? Oh. Got your flank now. Oh no, it's him again. Don't be so persistent. Your girlfriend will hate you. What did you say? Yurio said. Yurio, don't listen to her. Goose says, this way. Oh. Oh. That must have hurt. Sherla says, wait, why do I need to run? I guess we're gonna have a fight. Oh, not so shabby, little girl, Goose says. I like your style, but unfortunately for you, I'm not interested in girls under 18. I don't want you either. Huh. Whoa. Goose says, so now it's you. Goose says, you two are something. I've never run this hard. Sherla says, hey you, give me that bag. We got this back from him in the first place. Chris says, we didn't ask you to. You conceited girl. I have no mercy for women. Goose says, wait. Why is that sailor sleeping there? I can't believe it. The thief must have drugged everyone. You're right, Chris says. But that means this ship is just drifting, Sherla says. Oh no, Yurio says. What happens if we drift into Galga's lair? Don't panic, Goose says. Can anyone here pilot a ship? Everyone on the scene, not saying a word. I know who, Chris says. Uncle Huck. Who is he? Sherla says. Is he a sailor? He's my uncle. He's a bit strange, but he knows a lot of things. He may be able to help us. All right, Goose says. Let's call a temporary truce. We should let Uncle Huck give it a try. Why are you looking at me like that? I keep promises. That's my motto. You better keep your promise. I'll get Uncle Huck. Yurio says, Basre has the key to his room. I'll be back, Chris says. Goose says, so that Uncle Huck, can we count on him? Well, I can say I have a feeling that he is a great man. I hope you're right. There they are. Well, that was quick. Huck says, Chris told me everything. So there are only 5 people awake? Everyone do as I say. We should be able to get to Neri safely. Neri, sorry. Should? Goose says. You're not absolutely sure? No, I'm not. There is nothing absolutely sure in life. I love his green mustache. Archaeology and magic are all based on probability. I have no knowledge on how to navigate a ship either. Hey, that's nothing to brag about. But you can rest assured. Shirla says, how can we? Anyhow, what do you want to do now? Is that the tone of a person asking for help? You should be humble, thanking me for imparting my knowledge to you. Uncle Huck, Chris says, just shut up. The ship is drifting further while you are making your speech. Sorry, don't give up on your uncle. Okay, let's get to work. Yurio and Chris, you go the ropes on port. You two take care of the ropes on the starboard. Uncle, we're ready. Goose says, we're okay too. Alright, now let's do this. A cold wind blows down from the mountains of Menarth around this time of the year. Considering the ocean current and westerly wind, you should keep the sails 45 degrees to the left. It has been around 3 hours since you drifted off course, so I guess this adjustment will do. Yurio, release the ropes on your side. You on the starboard, pull the ropes with all you've got. Goose says, I never imagined I would do manual labor. Huck says, the sails are not taut enough. Pull the ropes harder. We're doing the best we can. Yurio says, my hands hurt. Yurio, if you complain like a wimp, you'll become a real wimp, Chris says. It doesn't hurt me at all. That was quick. That's it, Chris and Yurio. Keep up the good work. The sky is full of stars, but the five couldn't even sleep. Captain Jilba and his crew are still asleep because of the effects of sleeping pills. Huck's instructions continued throughout the night. I see a small light. That must be the coastline of Menarth. We're safe. They have effectively have sleeping pills applied to them. So what do you think of my instructions? They were pretty accurate, weren't they? Oh well. Yep, surveying the scene. Everyone has already fallen asleep. And these are awake. Captain Jilba says, I dozed off. I'm truly sorry. Captain Jilba, the ship is on its course. Yurio and others help navigate it. Chris got back the stolen belongings, and they are safely kept in the room. Logi says, you must have worked all night to keep the ship on its course. Tess says, Yurio and Chris saved us all. Let them sleep for a while. All right. But look at their innocent sleeping faces. I can't believe they pulled off a big stunt like that. Captain says, the wind is getting cold. They may catch cold sleeping here. Let's carry them inside. Basray should be up soon, so we'll handle the entry into the port. Huck, you did a great job. Ha ha ha, it's just another twist of fate. Him and his twists of fate. Yurio is yawning, says, I had a great sleep. It's funny, Chris says. Did we come back to our room and sleep? I bet I came back to my bed. I came back to my bed half asleep. It's so you, Yurio. Whoa. That's loud. Was that the sound of a bell? Yurio asked. We must have arrived in Neri. Yeah. Let's go up to the deck. Okay. Captain says, Yurio and Chris, you worked really hard. Without you, we couldn't have got the stolen belongings back, and our ship couldn't have reached Neri. Thank you so much. This is a small token of our appreciation. Keep it. Captain Jilba gave 200 piers to Yurio and Chris, his comrades on the ship. Thank you, Captain Jilba. Thank you. I almost forgot. Yurio says, I must return the motion sickness pills. Jilba says, keep those pills. It'll be a long journey. They may become useful. I hope you will arrive in Uldos safely. Take care. Yes, sir. Garten says, Yurio, you have a talent as a sailor. When you are done with your pilgrimage, join us on the Hawk Talon if you want to. Thank you for the offer, but I haven't decided what I want to do yet. Tanya says, ha ha ha. That's true. I was not doing anything serious until I turned 18. You should go now. I hate saying goodbyes. Hawk, Logie, and Tess are waiting down on the pier. Good luck. Chris says, thank you for teaching me how to cook. Don't mention it. Cooking requires love. The most delicious meal is one you cook with your love. Bolto says, but that couple was so strange. They disembarked the ship as soon as we got to the pier, even before the captain said goodbye. The chef says, go, Chris. Yurio is waiting for you. Well, at my age, people are easily moved to tears. Take good care of yourself, Chris says. See you again, Yurio says. Chris says, after our long pilgrimage is over, I'll come back to your ship someday. Basri says, you know what? Every time some pilgrims come on board, our captain gives them some chores to do to teach them the way life is. But I think the truth is that he is too embarrassed just to give money to the pilgrims. So many things happened during this trip, but we had a good time thanks to you, Yurio and Chris. Why don't we get together after your pilgrimage and talk about our experience over drinks? Logi says, we got our watch and coat back thanks to you. I can't thank you more. Tess says, so it was Mr. Heston, but I still can't believe he was the thief. I think we can learn a good lesson, Logi says. Above all, we had the good fortune of having met you. We must go now, Yurio and Chris. Chris says, wish all the happiness to you. Yurio says, take care. Thank you, Logi says. We'll be praying for your successful journey. Huck says, how are you feeling? I'm glad we entered the port safely. It was a meaningful trip. I didn't know you were such a reliable person, Uncle Huck. That was no difficult task. I just had to apply my knowledge. So what are you going to do now, Uncle? Yurio asks. Thank you for asking. The Moonlight Witch, my eternal research theme, also left many prophecies here in Minarth. I shall reveal what she wanted to say and where she wanted to guide us. Yurio says, no, what I meant was, what are you going to do about the money you borrowed? Oh, that. Fortunately, the captain gave me a considerable sum, so I don't have to worry about the research money for now. Uncle, seriously, you must pay back the money, you know. Mystery and knowledge are calling me. I'm sure we'll see each other again. Until then, so long. He's gone. Basri says, you should get going, too. I hate saying goodbyes. It's cold in Minarth, but people here are very warm-hearted. I hope you'll complete your pilgrimage safely. Yurio says, thank you for everything. I'll be a better cook next time we see each other. Basri says, that's good. I'll have my hopes up. Let's go, Chris. Yeah. The checks by the authorities are over, so we can get on with our next trip. I wonder what kind of passengers we'll have this time. I hope people like J and C will come aboard again. What is J and C? Yurio asked. It's your nickname. Oh, Yurio and Chris. Are you impressed with my artistic sense? It's not really artistic. Yurio says I can't comment on that. Sorry. No one is allowed on board without permission from the local authorities. Bear with me. Alright, there's some people around here. That's off the map. Oh, Neary, okay. Flippant Soldier says, it's a fine day. I feel like hiking on the tide path. I mean, walking on water. Hard-working Soldier says, ships traveling between countries are the target of stowaways and contraband goods. These problems may occur without the captain's knowledge. That's why we need to check the Hawk Talon. Please understand. Yurio says, I understand it well. Oh. Hey, you! You won't go any further once the authorities start their inspection. Keep that in mind. Okay. Well, we're not trying to get on the ship. Where's Captain Jilbo? Yurio and Chris, how do you find Neary? Isn't it a lovely town? Basically set one step into there. Mirio says, yes, a little too cold for me, though. What's going on? Well, I feel calm watching the water with the ship parked behind me. And here's the chef. It's been a long time talking to you face to face like this, Captain. Oh, I almost forgot. I have something for you. It's Sailor's Knife. Every crew member on the Hawk Talon has one. Sweet. Good thing we talked to him. So he handed us the Sailor's Knife. Take good care of it. Awesome. I spent a lot of time on ships, but this is the first time we had so many incidents in a single trip. Yo-Yo, Chris, you made the trip a really pleasant one. Sweet! Okay. So we're checking out Neri next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, have it. Always seek adventure. Have a good adventure.